St. John Progressive Missionary Baptist Church family and friends, please permit me to share my 45-second lesson on achieving inner peace and relaxation. You can spend hours searching for spiritual guidance from books, and teachers can be helpful, but I recommend a more direct route. You can bypass external sources and commune directly with God and find inner peace as well as relaxation. As you know, we live in a fast-paced world, and it's important to prioritize our mental well-being. Sometimes we need to start by taking a deep breath and repeat selected words a few times to center yourself. Sometimes it even helps to find a quiet place. What I do is I take a few moments to relax into an awareness of the presence and the power of God within and all around me. This helps find my guidance through centering prayer, choosing a single word or short phrase to repeat as a meditation exercise. Next, let's practice mindfulness by focusing on the present moment. You gotta pay closer attention to your surroundings, the sounds, the sensations in your body. Let go of any worries or distractions. You can even try saying meaningful words such as peace, light, joy, wholeness, and wisdom. This can help light a path and make guidance clear. Finally, find a quiet space to relax and unwind. Close your eyes, visualize a peaceful place or a positive memory. Allow yourself to let go of any tension or stress. If you try these techniques into your daily routine, you can experience a greater sense of inner peace and relaxation. Here's this week's assignment. Take care of yourself and prioritize your mental wellness.
offering. Let us pray. Most gracious and kind God, Lord, we thank you. Lord, we just thank you for waking us up this morning. Lord, we thank you for allowing us to see another Sunday. Lord, we ask you to bless this offering and let it be used for the upbuilding of your kingdom. Bless those who gave and bless those who had the heart to give but had it not. We thank you for what you've done and we thank you for what you're going to do. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Responsive reading will be from Romans chapter 8, verses 1 through 16. There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For what the law could not do, and that it was weak through the flesh, God sent his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh, and for sin, condemned sin in the flesh. For they that are after the flesh do mind the things of the flesh, but they that are after the Spirit, the things of the Spirit.
For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace.
Because the carnal mind is enmity against God, for it is not subject to the law of God, neither indeed can be.
So then they that are in the flesh cannot please God.
But ye are not in the flesh, but in the Spirit, if so be that the Spirit of God dwell in you. Now, if any man have not the Spirit of Christ, he is none of his.
And if Christ is in you, the body is dead because of sin, but the Spirit is life because of righteousness.
But if the Spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his Spirit that dwelt in you.
Therefore, brethren, we are dead not to the flesh, to live after the flesh.
For if ye live after the flesh, ye shall die. But if ye through the Spirit do mortify the deeds of the body, ye shall live.
For as many are dead to the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God.
For ye have not received the Spirit of bondage again to fear, but ye have received the Spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father, all together.
The Spirit itself bears witness with our spirit that we are the children of God.
Thank you. You may be seated.
Thank you. we say amen.
Amen.
We're having a marvelous time in the Lord. Let's praise God for these young people who sing out of their hearts and graciously serving us. It's just good to be in the house of the Lord and celebrating the goodness of our God. And thank God for your presence. We're going to continue now in our worship experience by asking the officers to come with the assistance of our ushers as we prepare to give to the Lord out of the abundance of his bountiful blessings.
Online giving, where your tithes, offerings, and donations are securely done through our website. You simply log on to stjohnprogressive.org, click on the online giving button, and follow the prompts. Also have the option to mail in tithes and offerings. Mail your donations to St. John Progressive Missionary Baptist Church, P.O. Box 75194, Tampa, Florida 33675. In my closing, the Bible says in Malachi 3:10, to bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in my house, and prove me now herewith, saith the Lord of hosts, if I will not open you the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing that you shall not have room enough to receive it. We thank you so much. Remember, take care of you and take care of others. God bless you.
And offerings. We ask now that you bless our gifts that they may be used for the upbuilding of your kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Sister Munro in the service this morning. We praise God for bringing her out of the hospital back into the presence of our brothers and sisters in Christ. I see Sister Jewel back there. Praise God for you. God continues to bless his people. He's still a doctor in the sick room. We're going to prepare now for a message for the day. And the person of Reverend Barron Banks is going to share with us from the Word of God. And we ask that you prepare your hearts and minds to receive it. We're going to ask that you will join us in singing our congregational hymn, number 191, Glory to His Name. Choir is going to lead us in the singing of the hymn.
the cross for this precious fountain is free to all a that flows from Calvary's mountain. Oh, in the cross, in the cross, oh, be my Lord, be associate ministers and to the ministers' wives and to the deacons and deaconesses and to each and every one of you, I'm honored to have this opportunity. I don't take it for granted that I'm given this opportunity. But if you have your Bibles, there's a word for us in Luke, the 9th chapter. It will begin reading at verse 23. That's Luke, the 9th chapter. It will begin reading at verse 23. Luke 9:23. You have it, say amen. Luke, the 9th chapter, verse 23. You have it? And he said to them all, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross daily and follow me. Thank you so much. You may be seated. This morning, I'd like to speak to you from the subject, bearing your cross. Bearing your cross. When I was younger, I had the dream of being a professional athlete. I can remember watching the great feats of the greats Barry Sanders, Tampa's own Dwight Gooden, Ken Griffey Jr., my favorite basketball player of all time, Magic Johnson, and Michael Jordan. Me, like a lot of kids, just wanted to be like Mike. But unfortunately, I stopped growing when I reached a height of 5'9". And my NBA dream died with it. But when I got to college, I knew I wanted to get into the healthcare field and either become a physician or some sort of doctor. But in order to become a doctor, there were some requirements that I had to meet. In other words, I couldn't just show up one day and just start operating on somebody, or just start pulling teeth, or just start prescribing medication. You see, I had to go through a journey. My journey started at Hillsborough Community College, where I spent 3 years. Then it ventured to go to Morehouse College, where I spent another 2 years. I did post-bac for a year at Morehouse School of Medicine, answered my call to the ministry, and then God led me to go to dental school at Meharry to spend another 4 years. And I had to do another year residency, and I had to pass another more and more tests. In other words, I had to prove my worth in order to be in the profession. And likewise, we have to do that as Christians. In other words, there are some sacrifices that we have to make in order to be followers of Christ. There are some things you got to do, even beyond going to the simple church services. Have you ever gone beyond the simple church membership or the denominational association to find out what it really means to be a follower of Christ? You see, as believers, each of us have a responsibility to the body of Christ. But there are too many of us who have no idea what that means. I know things are rough. Since we are 4 years removed from one of the biggest pandemics that happened since the HIV/AIDS epidemic of the 80s, churches are still recovering and trying to rebuild, if they are back reconvening at all. And with the advent of the internet and social media and technology, some of us were going to bedside Baptists during COVID, and some of us continue to go to bedside Baptists. Now, there's nothing wrong with the technologies. We want to be able to reach everybody that we need to reach. But there's something about gathering with fellow believers and followers of Christ. You see, there is still a responsibility that we must reach in order for us to live up to our responsibilities. In this text, we consider Jesus, as he requires what men think of him. And he often considers his own suffering on earth. And he prompts his disciples to consider their sufferings for him. And in considering public opinion, Jesus found that the public saw him in every image except the one that he wanted to project. Some saw him as Elijah. Some saw him as John the Baptist. Others saw him as just one of the great prophets. But his disciples recognized him as the true Son of God. And you see, concerning his sufferings, Christ told his disciples not to dwell on the fact that he was the Christ. His works through the suffering and death and resurrection would testify who he really is. You see, his disciples were told to prepare for a life of self-denial and suffering, noting that any of them were not willing to make the sacrifices to help build the kingdom or could make no claims to salvation. You see, in these instances, Christ painted a picture of the nature of the word and the manner of the testimony and the attitude of his disciples. You see, the nature of the believer is a service will often be misunderstood as the public forms its own opinion of what a believer is supposed to be. And a lot of times, people on the outside will try to define who you are or who you should be, regardless of whatever facts may be happening. You see, Christ healed many. He fed crowds. He performed miracles. And public opinion put him in a very category other than the one he wanted to be in. And he was often frustrated by what people thought, as many people can label and try to label us or put us in a box. You see, Christ was once consoled to know that those close to him understood the true nature of his work. And he encouraged his disciples not to devote their time to shaping his image, because his deeds and eventually his suffering on the cross would make his sonship evident to all. Jesus charged them and commanded them to tell that no man the thing that he's doing. He wanted the works to testify of his sonship in a way that people came to conclude that he was the Lord. He told his disciples that if they were to share in the kingdom, it would require considerable self-denial on their part.
And the disciples took this challenge and went far beyond what Christ required him and even gave their lives. My brothers and sisters, this morning, are we willing to go far and beyond of what we feel is required of us for the upbuilding of our kingdom? Ask yourself that question to keep the answer to yourselves. You see, the disciples and the apostles that followed him knew the meaning of self-denial, and they took it at face value. But while Jesus was curious to know the public opinion, he did not allow the public opinion to sway him from his heavenly mission. You see, this seems difficult in this day and age of social media, where it seems that everyone is trying to craft an image that does not exist. Whether it be on Facebook, whether it be on Instagram, or we still call it Twitter, but it's called X now, or TikTok. We often see false images of people trying to fool the world into thinking either they are happier than they really are, or they have more than they really have, or they're doing better than what they're really doing. You see, today there are many of those who are in a direction in life that is too easily influenced by public opinion, whether it be followers on social media or likes on Instagram. Even in places of high government, we know right now in the state of Florida, we have a governor who tried to be like the orange guy in the White House and making all kind of attacks on Black history and all kind of attacks on DEI. And if you're not careful, they are going back for the Civil Rights Act of 1964 if we don't get out and vote. But he's allowing public perception of what he thinks should be to figure out how this Florida government should be run. But it's up to us as followers of Christ, and it's up to us as people of conscience to influence the people around us to not get where they are disheveled with the government, but to be our public and be a light that we're supposed to be, that they do not lose hope in what God has for us. Amen. And they continue to live a life that is pleasing to God and live a life that's pleasing to the community. But you see in this text, the public was wrong about Jesus. And often the public's based on this limited or misinformation gets and gives factless info about the issues of the day. You see, I practice dentistry in nursing homes throughout the state of Florida. And one of the networks that you see is Fox News, that's blasting on a lot of these television stations. And this info is spread all over the world. And I used to watch Fox News from time to time because I used to tell myself I wanted to know what the other side is thinking. But I had to watch myself consuming that stuff because I didn't want it to creep into my subconscious. You see, it can be good to know what others are saying, but it's not good for any other person to chart another person's course. And life based on and base their life on opinions of others. You see, if you build a house, in the minds of others, it's too small, or too far removed, or in the wrong neighborhood. If you buy a car, it's the wrong brand, or it's not new. If you take a job, people will say that you have waited too long. Or if you decide not to take the job, people will say you have not waited long enough. You see, if you're not careful, you will spend your entire life trying to please people who do not care about you. And they can care less or if you live or die. You see, Jesus knew the direction he was headed. And he held steadfastly to his mission, despite what the public thought of him. You see, the disciples knew Jesus intimately as the Savior. But Jesus commanded them not to spend time arguing with people trying to convince them of who he was. He said his works, his miracles, his suffering, his death, and his resurrection would tell the story. That's why you can't waste your time arguing with people trying to convince them of your purpose. You have to walk in the purpose that God gave you. And you have to be the best version of yourself and not the best version of what you want people to think you are. So what, you can't sing like brother and sister so-and-so? God gave you your own gift. So what, you can't pray like Deacon Galvin or the late Sister Frances Williams? God gave you your own gift. So what you can't preach like Pastor Banks, God gave you your own gift. If you have done a great work, there is no need for anyone to say that you are great. They can simply point to the work that you have done, and it will speak for itself. But you see, some of us get caught up waiting to get the approval of others or get credit for the things that we are doing, that it cripples us from walking into our greatness. You see, greatness is not a title that is conferred, but is a title that is earned by the accumulation of your good works. That is why Jesus warned his disciples not to focus on building his image, because there is too much work to be done, and the work will build the image.
Today, those who will follow Christ.
Today, those who will follow Christ would have to follow, know to take up your cross, and know to live the example of what he has given to us. You don't have to say, "I'm a minister," because your service and ministry speaks for itself. You don't have to say, "I'm a good deacon," because your work as a deacon should speak for itself. You don't have to say, "I'm a good choir member," because your work in the choir would speak for itself. You don't have to say, "I'm a good usher," because your work on the usher board will speak for itself. You don't have to say, "I'm a good pew member," because your work in the pew and outside of the pews will speak for itself. You see, if a surgeon tells you that they are a good surgeon, or if a lawyer tells you that they're a good lawyer, and you don't hear from their patients, and you don't hear from their clients, I would advise you to run the other way. Because something is wrong with this picture if those that you have done work for do not speak highly of you. That's why I like what my late grandmother, Sister Elizabeth Rose, used to say all the time. May the works I've done speak for me. What is the work of a believer? You see, being a believer sometimes requires costly choices. And a believer may lose a profit edge because he refuses to sacrifice the quality of the goods and services for profit. Professionals may lose out on advancements and chances to enhance themselves because they refuse to compromise on the principles that they are learned. And see, there's a saying in dominoes that we hear all the time. I don't know if y'all play dominoes, that all money is not good money. And this means just because some opportunities may look good now. You know, when that something is not right and you may jump on that opportunity today, surely it will come back to you and bite you in the back in the future. You see, Jesus never said to his disciples that bearing the cross would be easy, only that it was necessary. And as believers, we must understand that the life that we are called to live is not going to be easy either. But it is necessary. You see, Jesus was not afraid of the cross. He carried it to Calvary. But might Jesus bear this cross alone and all the world go free? You see, there have been many who have turned down the cross. And there are many who have been turned down the opportunity to bear the cross, despite its many blessings. You see, the rich young ruler turned down salvation because he wanted it without taking up the cross. But must Jesus bear this cross alone? Felix and Drusilla turned down the cross because they wanted to wait until a more convenient season. But must Jesus bear this cross alone? Agrippa turned down the cross because although he was almost persuaded, but he did not follow Christ. Must Jesus bear this cross alone? You see, I'm so glad we have a pastor who is not afraid to bear the cross. He's pastored this great church and made many souls to Christ. And so now that we learn what we're supposed to be, and we learn that we are supposed to bear the cross, there's a cross for everyone, and there's a cross for me. My brothers and my sisters, there is power in the cross. How do I know there's power in the cross? Because one Friday, Jesus put an old rugged cross on his shoulders. Jesus, Mary's baby. Jesus, the lily of the valley. Jesus, my bridge over troubled water. Jesus, my bread when I get hungry. Jesus, my water when I get thirsty. Jesus, my lawyer in the courtroom. Jesus, my doctor in the sick room. took an old rugged cross on his shoulders on a hill called Calvary. He died, didn't he die? But right early one Sunday morning, he got up with all power in his hand. Walk right tower, talk right power, live right power, pray right power. At the cross, the neglected get attention. At the cross, the outcast find a new home. At the cross, problems find solutions. At the cross, delivering questions to find evasive answers. At the cross, heartaches go away. At the cross, crying eyes will be dried and burdens at the cross. At the cross, at the cross. When I first saw the light and the burdens of my heart rolled away, it was there by faith that I received my sight. I am happy all the day. Are you gonna bear your cross today? Is there anybody in here that's gonna bear that cross today? Can you say yes? Say yes. Say yes.
Everybody standing. Must Jesus bear the cross alone? All the world go free. No, there is a cross for everyone. And there's a cross for me. Gracious God, how we thank you for the privilege of being a part of the family of God and accept the responsibility of carrying our cross for the kingdom of God. Bless us now to continue on in your name. We can't forget to give you the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. The doors of the church are open. The invitation is extended for someone to come. The Bible declares that if you believe in your heart and you confess with your mouth that Jesus is the Christ and he's the Son of God, you can be saved. Would you come?
Pray now for those that have come requesting prayer, intervening on behalf of family members. Our gracious and heavenly Father, we come into your presence with thanksgiving in our hearts to thank you for the love and kindness that you've showered upon us. Most of all, we thank you for salvation through the blood of Jesus that gives us the privilege of approaching the throne of grace. And Father, we've come now on behalf of this family. We thank you for being a doctor that have never lost a case. We don't have to send you anywhere. You're everywhere present at the same time. We just ask that you manifest your presence in the life of this loved one who is going through health challenges. Allow your healing virtue to saturate her body. Give her deliverance from whatever ails her. And Father, we thank you for the faith that has been demonstrated here today, that we can touch and agree on her behalf. We thank you now and we give you praise. the healing that will take place. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 God bless you. All right. Well, that's good. You're in the right place. Keep on coming. Keep on coming. What's up? All right. Praise report.
Good morning, family. Just want to thank God for my son. I want to thank y'all for your prayers. When he was out in the world and now he's back home. And continue to pray for my son and my family. In the name of Jesus. Thank you.
Our God is an awesome God. Satan desires to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But Jesus said, I am come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. And what we do is continue to pray for our children. Continue to know that God's grace is sufficient. And my mother prayed for me. And her prayers continue to cover me, even though I was 450 miles away from home. There's something about a mother's prayers. I never will forget when I was at the University of South Florida, and when I would call home on Sunday evenings, my mother would ask me, well, did you go to church today? So I made sure I found my way into somebody's church so that when I talked to mom, I can say, yes, I went to church. And so, something about a mother's prayer. So continue to pray for your children, and God will continue to demonstrate his power in their lives. Let's say amen for the message and the messenger. Amen. We all have a responsibility to carry our cross. And when we talk about the cross, it implies and insinuates that every day is not going to be sunshine. But through it all, God is going to take us through. Thank you so much for that powerful message. Membership ministry is coming now, and then our clerk is coming with the announcements.
Good morning, St. John.
Good morning.
Acknowledging Pastor Banks and Lady Banks in her absence. Greetings from the St. John Progressive Missionary Baptist Church. We take this opportunity to extend a warm welcome to our in-person and online visitors. To connect better with you, we ask that you take a few minutes to fill out our members and visitors information form. Please use the QR code located on the St. John website. Thank you for taking the time to complete the form. We look forward to getting to know you better and rejoicing with you in the house of the Lord. God bless you and thank you for worshiping with us. If there are any first-time visitors, please stand and remain standing. Okay. Thank you.
All right, thank you so much. Let's praise God for our visiting members. Do we have any visitors at all? This morning we had some visitors and they say, well, I'm not a first time visitor, but I would have stood if you had asked me to stand. So give me an opportunity to stand. All right, thank you so much.
Good afternoon, St. John. Recognizing Pastor Banks and Lady Banks in her absence. Please continue to remember the sick, shut-in, bereaved families in prayer, as well as those in the hospital and those are recuperating at home. We thank God that we don't have any new or additional bereaved families this week. However, we do ask that you continue to remember all our bereaved families in prayer. The youth department will be selling boiled peanuts today over by the Christian Life Center at 11 a.m. worship services after this service. A vacation Bible school planning meeting / breakfast will be held on Monday 11th from 10 a.m. through 12 noon in the Life Center. Vacation Bible School will be held July 15th through the 19th. A reminder, auxiliary and ministry leaders, a planning meeting for our 100th church anniversary will be held on April 23rd at 6:30 p.m. in the Life Center. The mission ministry will be in the foyer after the 8 and 11 a.m. services. For anyone that has not completed the form to spiritually adopt a child from the Compassion Service, any youth interested in attending the district or state convention or congress must submit their names by April 30th. Eligible youth must be 10 years of age or older, attend mission, and is active in the ministry. 10 and under can participate if they are competing in an event. Congratulations to Sis Heaven Stephens, who graduated from Bethune-Cookman. We will be having a Deacon's Appreciation on June 15 at 6 o'clock p.m. in the Christian Life Center. We need you to register in a grants on the church website. Deadline for registration is June 2nd, 2024. Further details to come. We are having a Mother's Day luncheon Saturday, May 4th at 11 a.m. This event is free and open to everyone. Please sign up on the bulletin board in the annex if you plan to attend. This will be in the Christian Life Center. We are also having a teenager brunch April 27th on Saturday at 12 p.m. in the Christian Life Center. RSVP to Sis Annie Horn by Monday, April 22nd. And Reverend Dr. Banks Pastor, Sis Rose Watson Church, Clark Isis, we are supporting.
Amen. God bless you. Our young people do a marvelous job, and we thank God for our youth workers who are working with them to prepare them for their role of leadership in our church at the appropriate time. Thank you so much for your presence. We pray God's continued blessings upon each of you as we continue to lift up the name of Jesus and continue to bear our crosses. All minds are clear. We're standing. Father, we thank you for the privilege of worship, and we thank you for the word of God that have gone forth with power, clarity, and authority. Bless us now as we depart from this place to serve. Continue to lead us and guide us in the way that you'd have us to go. Allow our lights to shine ever so brightly so that men can see our good works and glorify you in heaven. Continue to bless those who are sick and those who are bereaved. Continue to bless them as you see that they need. We ask it all in Jesus' name. Now may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit rest and remain with us henceforth and forever. Let us all say.